Good evening. This is Josh Cunnings and Dan, what's your last name?
McAllister, my friend.
Dan McAllister, who I've just recently had the pleasure of acquainting myself with. And we're here coming to you on the last evening, the final night of what has been an absolutely epic show, hasn't it, Dan?
It's been amazing. I've been at the booth the whole time, probably like you.
Yeah.
But the things I've seen are incredible, yeah.
So yeah, we've both been our own booth refugees, you know. I've been a slave to the boogie booth.
Yes.
But I knew something special would happen at this 2017 National Heirloom Expo. And what is special that happened is the individual that I am sitting next to. And he's doing something that is so profoundly amazing. Crop swap, and it just went live. Dan, fill my audience in.
Yo, so I'm a gardener. I learned to garden 4 years ago. I moved into a house with a band. That's why I look like this. And I read Square Foot Gardening. I read this book, and I started watching John Kohler and videos with this guy in him. And I learned about the soil, and I learned about caring for microbiology, and I learned about the interconnectedness of ecological systems and how it's a lot effing easier if you just do it in accordance, and you'll have less insect problems and less diseases, and it's an immune system. And so I fell in love with gardening. I became obsessed with it. I converted my whole backyard into it. I built a compost pile. I watched more videos, read more books, converted my front yard in it, did all of this. And then I was in my yard one night with a headlight and overwhelmed by how delicious my dinosaur kale was. I had so much dinosaur kale. I had juiced it. I dehydrated it. I had used all of it, and I still had leftover dinosaur kale. And of course, my dinosaur kale was grown in minerals with C90, with all the really good stuff,
right,
with biochar. I'd expended love on it, and it was beyond organic. Yet I was still buying lemons, quote lemons, from a store next to me. And there was probably somebody buying kale that had lemons. And so that's when the idea for Crop Swap, a mobile app to trade fruits and vegetables, came to me, and it just went live 10 minutes ago, which is freaking weird.
And that was about 2 years ago that you had your Crop Swap moment?
Dude, it was like 2.5 years ago.
Uh-huh.
And I had it, and it killed me. And I like had this existential crisis where I reached out to everybody I know who did tech, and I was like, how do I effing do this? Then I like talked to Silicon Valley guys, and they're like, you have no idea what you're doing. So I read a bunch of business books, and as a liberal dude, reading Rich Dad, Poor Dad and stuff like that is a real mind fuck. But I did all these things to get in that character and understand the world. And I finally did, and we made this app. We did a Kickstarter. We raised $26,000. We don't want to take any stupid investors. We don't want investors in Amazon that owns Whole Foods that has an interest in keeping systems, or those systems of here's a meal delivered to your house where you don't have to move from your couch and it's wrapped in plastic. These are all our problems of our current food system. Waste, things picked before they're ripe so the nutrition sucks. Things gas with ethylene so they appear red and the flavor's shit. A tomato is grown not for flavor and nutrition, it's grown for weight and its ability to withstand bruises. So we don't need to do that. We have people trading in our neighborhoods. We need to get to know one another instead of holing up in our domiciles and being scared of people. That's the thing, you get to know people. So I'm not even making money on this app. This app is free to download because a lot of people be like, there's already a Facebook group to do this. Awesome. I'm not proprietary with this. I'm not Monsanto genetic, like trademarking life. I'm not doing that. If more people are trading food, I'm so blessed and I'm happy to be a part of that that conversation.
So it's an open source concept?
Yeah, dude, of course it's open source. I mean, I can't do this. As far as if somebody wants to do this or take ideas, dude, don't totally. In the app, basically what you do, and we'll show you video of this in a second, you upload your garden. So you take a picture of a tomato. If you're growing a lychee tomato from rare seeds, you say it's a tomato, it's a lychee tomato. You take a picture of your tomato. You can take like 5 pictures of your tomato.
Right.
Then you'll say, hey, is this a tomato, like a harvestable tomato, like you can eat, a plant, because you can trade plant starts, or a seed? We want people trading seeds like the freaking founding fathers did. We want people trading seeds. We want people trading plants. I've done the thing, and I know you have too, where you start like some bomb tomatoes from a seed company, and instead of buying total garbage Home Depot tomatoes, I have these plant starts, but I have nowhere to put them. So now on our app, you can trade this stuff. So you should always be able to trade this. But here's the cool part. With your tomato, you can say, my lychee tomato, I can say, hey, I'm growing it, and I'm using diatomaceous earth and neem oil and Dr. Bronner's soap for insect. You can put all these as tags.
What?
You can say I'm a veganic gardener. It's funny.
Crop swap is the future.
Here, this is a true free market. Yeah, free market capitalism, and I put that in air quotes, is completely commandeered by other interests and hedging and a lot of other funny business. This is a true free market. market, because a pomegranate is not $3 in the store. A pomegranate, if I have 10 freaking pomegranate trees, is gonna be pretty cheap in price. And that pomegranate, that guy wants to move that, and if somebody else wants access to fresh food, the price goes down, everybody's happy, that guy makes a little coin, or he trades for other stuff. This is how it should work. There's nothing more atrocious than a grocery store selling plastic fruits and vegetables that taste like nothing and throwing away 50% of those in a dumpster, which turns to fucking methane, okay? And then you have somebody whose tree is rotting, and then you have somebody buying that thing from a store. This is an absurd system. And I also want to say, like you were talking ecologically, like the mycelium, we do need to copy ecological systems, and this whole thing is connecting people, because we don't need to be scared of people.
Right.
We need
to talk to people. Instead of trying to master those systems and reconfigure those systems, control those systems, we need to go back to working with nature, not against nature, and we're preaching to the choir right here. But the energy in you, the emotional, I mean, my God, how do you even have it left in? You just did 3 days at this show, bro, and you launched your app live today.
I have to.
And it's officially called Crop Swap, right?
It's called Crop Swap.
Look it up. Crop Swap. That's too easy.
And I know I'm like repping Josh's shirt right now, and I'm doing this whole thing, but this isn't an ad. This is like I said, this is sincerely like, I was really influenced by Josh's like open source compost tea recipe. I like that first of all, I learned all about this from you.
Oh yeah, we're gonna go back to talking about how I influenced
you.
No,
but your neem oil explanation is great. I always send that when I give garden classes. I just send that link to that Battle of the Bugs video. I even know the name of it.
Wow.
But the point is talking about these things and understanding microbiology, as you know, it's this thing where once your brain clicks in how nature kind of works, and none of us would claim to know how nature
works,
but you start to see hints, and then nothing is like as intimidating, you know, to people to get that. So that's what I learned through people like you and John, and I'm sincere in my thanks for that.
She is so gentle, Mother Nature, no matter how powerful, and to be able to understand her is basically, it's a false dream. I mean, soil biologists, the most esteemed on Earth, know less than 1% of the life forms that are really going on beneath us.
Right.
And so why destroy it? Right. Why try to poison it? And why are you paying to poison your own planet, poison your own minds, poison everything? You're actually paying a lot. You're a slave to pay for it all.
Yes.
Crop Swap gives you a new freedom-based future, one built on agri-hoods. All right. When you talk about these lemons from your neighbor's tree, when you talk about open source compost tea, whether it's money or knowledge, it's like manure. It's being spread around, and go local and just keep on spreading everything like that beautiful matrix in the soil that you build, the mycorrhizal fungal web of life that supports a whole forest and supports all of us, rather than cutting it and slicing it and dicing it and trying to control it and own it and put some false economical value on it, which has nothing to do with this Crop Swap system. Gets me so excited because it resonates with my core belief, Dan, which is that health is our only wealth.
All right, so that was my powerful interview with Dan McCollister, creator of that awesome app. This is Josh with Boogie Brew. Thanks for watching. Please share and subscribe. And we'll see you next time.